quality as they were secure in the absence of competition. Now there is an increased exposure to ideas from around the world, as well as access to new materials, newer technologies and global competition. Indian manufacturers were thus compelled to improve their quality standards. Economic liberalisation also meant that we could, for the first time, take our own goods and services out into the world. But in doing so, we felt that looking Indian was a disadvantage. This was because Indian industrial products were often associated with poor quality. So to get a look in, our companies tried to make their products look as if they were from anywhere, with no evidence of Indian cultural overtones. This was feasible because English was the language of corporate work in India. To facilitate this, white people were often hired by Indian companies in customer-facing roles. Or Indian employees assumed Western identities. We all know about Siddharth, Paul, Sid, and Neelakantan, or Neel for short. So to reassure their customers and make them feel at home, business environments in India mimic those of corporations in America. After liberalization, and for the export sector especially, design in the corporate sector was thus deliberately acultural for business reasons. Our Indian identity was underplayed or suppressed. It only came in the way of success. This suppression of our Indian identity was made swifter because economic liberalization coincided with the telecommunications revolution.